When we hear about breast cancer survivors, the assumption is usually that they're free of the disease, but that's not always the case. Sometimes the cancer takes a form that is treatable, but not curable. Tonight, Ann Jacobs, in her own words, describing living with breast cancer that has now spread to other parts of her body.
I got a sonogram, and it showed I had two tumors, and a biopsy showed that they were cancerous. And
I'm sorry, two tumors in the same breast?
In the same breast, in my left breast, yeah. And I got the call from my doctor letting me know. I know I was in shock because I hung up the phone and I said to my husband, okay, honey, I have breast cancer. Can we get a house cleaner now? Had three boys and a great husband, but I told him, you know, you might not raise the kids right, so I have to be around for a while. Mm-hmm. So take all the breast tissue off me as you can.
Anne's fight against cancer wasn't over. The disease returned, this time in her back.
So what a shock.
A complete shock. Yeah, I was very proactive in the first diagnosis of what do I have to do. The second time, I could barely breathe. I'd drive by my kids' school and I would burst into tears because I thought I was going to die. I thought that was it. So that's what I do now. I live with the cancer. One of the things that I do is I volunteer for Save Ourselves, which is a nonprofit organization here. And we go to high schools and we do a check it out assembly. That it's called, and we teach girls about the breast cancer risks and how to do breast self-exams. I have good days and bad days, but most of them are good. And my kids don't really remember that I have breast cancer all the time, so then I know I'm doing a good job.
To become a part of this weekend's Race for the Cure, log on to KCRA.com, look in the As Seen On section. You'll have a lot of company out there, about 22,000 people expected to team up. So.
And you know what? Almost everybody out there has a story, whether it's their own or somebody who's close to them, you know?
It affects one in every eight women. Yeah. And you think about all of those families and everyone who loves all of those women, and it really affects a ton of people.
It's its own community. Yeah.